not quite a beautiful day in New York City. And this is why I canceled my vacation. Welcome back to, of course, They're Honking. Welcome back to the channel. So it's actually a little prettier now that I got outside and started walking around. The rain kind of stopped and it's actually pretty nice out here. Not too cold, not too warm. Perfect vest temperature, as you can see. And right now we're actually going to meet Andriana at her work. She is getting out a little early today. I still don't know if she's gonna tell you what she's doing now, but we'll see. Maybe I'll ask her while we're down there. But on today's video, since I'm out and about, I wanted to go ahead and talk about a few things, a few interesting facts about me that you probably don't know. So let's get into it. And as per usual, I had to fill up the Metro card for Andriana because that's what a good husband does. So I don't know if you can hear this or not in the background, but the very first interesting fact you probably don't know about me is that I am allergic to kiwi. So I actually found out I was allergic to kiwi in college because I accidentally had, well, I purposely had one of those strawberry kiwi, what do they call it? Crystal Light drinks or whatever. Put the powder in the water and it's strawberry kiwi flavor. So I had an enormous glass of that. And then about 4 hours later, I woke up with hives all over my back. Never had hives before. I had no idea what they were. I was itching like crazy. And then all of a sudden, the hives just started growing all over my entire body, including my face. So like anybody, when they're 18 years old, we rush to the urgent care and they obviously diagnose it as hives. Then I got a nice shot of Benadryl in my bum and went home and fell fast asleep because that's what Benadryl does to you. So what did I do when I woke up from that sleep? Well, I had another glass of strawberry kiwi drink. And guess what? The exact same thing happened to me and I went back to the same urgent care for a second shot of Benadryl. So it was the second time around where I actually realized what the cause was, and that was the kiwi component of the strawberry kiwi drink, because I eat strawberries all the time, never had an issue, but the kiwi is what did me in. So let's just say since whenever that was, 10 years ago, I haven't had a kiwi drink or a kiwi fruit since that day and never had an issue. So the second fact you probably don't know about me is that I am also afraid of vomiting. I'm not really afraid of it, I just thoroughly dislike it. And honestly, I have probably vomited one time in my entire life, and I will never forget that day. It was also in college, and it was because I had severe food poisoning after eating pizza or something, and it was the most miserable experience of my entire life. Still to this day. I think I vomited for maybe like 8 hours straight, and that was my first real experience with just aggressive vomiting. I know this is TMI, too much information, but I'm trying to get my point across that it was terrible, and I actually ended up having to go to the urgent care to get IV fluids and rehydration after that day. So ever since that day, I've been very particular about eating well-cooked foods and all that stuff. My wife thinks I'm crazy, but I really just hate vomiting. So if you hate vomiting, let me know in the comments below. I think it's called emetophobia, if I'm not mistaken. That's sort of me. I don't really mind it. I just don't want to be the one that's vomiting. Also, did I just find another giant tractor with a huge truck tire? This one clearly isn't as big as the last one, but not that bad. It's probably like 5 feet tall or something. I'm pretty sure you all watching this vlog probably think I'm like the most random scatterbrain person in the entire planet. Did I just stumble upon the cutest street in all of New York City? I think I did. So this is actually a private New York street, which I actually saw this on TikTok recently because it's being taken over by like all of these Instagrammers and people like me. No, a lot of people do TikToks on the street because it's really quiet, it's cobblestone, it's gorgeous, and it's kind of secluded away from everybody. But it's also a good time now that I'm here to talk about the next interesting facts about me. And that is that many of you do not know that I was a competitive swimmer for like almost 18 years. I'm a two-time high school state champion in Georgia in the 200 IM and 100 breast, and also a Division I NCAA All-American at the University of Georgia, where I got a scholarship to swim there. So I was pretty much a competitive swimmer for the better half of my life, and my last swim meet was probably in 2007, I believe. And I think since then, in the last 13 years, I've probably been in the water like one time, literally one time. That's how burnt out I was from doing that my whole life. This is Washington Square Park. So Washington Square Park is iconic. It is the southern tip of Fifth Avenue here in Manhattan. And it's located in the West Village or Greenwich Village area, mostly West Village, or kind of on the border. You get the point. I think it's modeled after the Arc de Triomphe. I'm not entirely sure, so I'll have to do some research and put some text on this video. Might I add, we also did our engagement pics in this park, and if I can find some, I'll post one right now. I think we took pictures like over here in front of the big fountain and also maybe the arch. I don't know. They were kind of cute, so I'll post one if I can find one. So the next interesting fact that you probably don't know about me is that at first I didn't really want to do YouTube. It wasn't until my friend Antonio Webb, MD, who also has a pretty big YouTube channel, and you may or may not know him, he wanted me to do a day in the life of an interventional radiologist video on his channel. I declined for a long time because I was purely focusing on Instagram back in like 2018, and I didn't know how I would be on camera. So I ended up posting a timeline of me on call on my Instagram stories, which may actually be on my Instagram still. But he saw that and told me to just make a video instead. Film it instead of doing quick little Instagram stories. Film it, send it to him, he'll post it on his channel and see how it does. Luckily, it ended up doing pretty well. I think it had like well over 100,000 views on his channel. And then after I saw it do so well on his channel, I thought, why am I giving him my content and I should just do all this content myself? So that's exactly what I did. So honestly, if it weren't for him, I probably wouldn't be doing YouTube right now. He kind of showed me that it was possible, and once I saw how successful it could be, I started doing it. So the next interesting fact you probably don't know about me is that I've only ever owned Jeeps in my entire life. I've actually owned probably 5 of them, I think. I've always had Jeeps. All Jeep Cherokees or Jeep Grand Cherokees. Those are the only cars I've ever owned in my entire life. And in fact, you saw the last one I had, which I sold to that high school student, and that was the last Jeep I ever had. And now I don't have a car because I don't need one. The next fact you probably don't know about me is that my pant size is a 33-35. So my waist is 33 inches, my pant size or my inseam is 35 inches. And if you can imagine by those numbers, which are both odd numbers and odd for more ways than one, there aren't many pant sizes that fit, and there aren't many pants that come in those sizes to begin with. So you can imagine I spend quite a bit of time at the tailor. But on the same topic to that, I also wear a size 12.5 sneaker and 12.5 shoe, which, as you can imagine, is also very difficult to find sneakers in that size because most companies don't even make them. And you all know me pretty well at this point, and many of you probably know that I'm kind of a sneakerhead these days, and the only problem with that is they don't make many shoes in size 12.5. So a lot of times I just have to go up to a size 13, or sometimes even size down to a size 12. So basically what I'm trying to say is I never have pants that fit, and I never have shoes that fit. All right, so this next fact may come at a surprise to you. You see, I happen to be claustrophobic, which is kind of ironic given the specialty that I'm in, because CT scanners I can do. I've had a CT scan, I've gone through the CT scanner, not a big deal. It's open on both sides, it's pretty wide open in the middle. It's a big old donut, slide right in there, good to go. But the MRI, not so much. I walk by these MRI machines every single day and I look down the bore and I don't think I could ever, ever go into one. Unless, of course, you provided me with a ton of medications in order to do so, because how long that tube is and how close to your body it is just gives me the heebie-jeebies thinking about it. If I were to get an MRI, I think what I would have to do is A, you'd have to put some headphones on me. B, you'd have to cover my eyes, blindfold me before I even walked in the room. C, you'd have to give me some Valium or some sort of anxiolytic medicine. I couldn't do it if I could see it, or I couldn't do it without medication. That's it. All right, so that officially concludes this vlog. I hope you all saw some cool New York City locations, and I also hope you enjoyed some of those interesting facts about me. With that being said, I'll leave you all here. Make sure you smash the like, subscribe button, follow me on Instagram. Make sure you like this video. Every time you give a thumbs up on a video, it really helps the channel, it helps the YouTube algorithm. So do that, follow me on TikTok, and otherwise, I'll see you all on the next video.